on the dais, esteemed Mr. Jyotirdit Sindhya ji, Minister of State for Commerce and Industry, my senior colleague Mr. Arun Mehra, Member Planning Commission, Mr. G.K. Arun, Sri V.K. Agarwal, Arun Bhardwaj, ladies and gentlemen, a very good morning to all of you. This ministry attaches a lot of importance to the India MSME Summit, which is being hosted with the help of ISMI Economic Times. The points raised by the previous speakers are very important. For any country, MSMEs form the backbone of the industry. If the MSMEs are doing well, the country is doing well. Also, they provide a lot of jobs. India is a country of young people. India has the largest number of young people in the world. If we have to provide jobs, then the answer lies in the micro small sector. So what we have to do? The role is set out for us. If we want to create jobs in remote areas, forested areas, rural areas, we have to start thinking how we can promote micro and small sector. In India, we have about 45% of the manufactured output coming out from this sector, 40% of the exports. One point which was raised by Mr. Bhardwaj was the mismatch between the skills and the manpower available. Government of India has given a lot of emphasis for the skilling of the country. Our vision is by 2022, we should have 500 million skilled people. It is quite a tall order. One has to really step up, in fact, jump up to at least 10 times whatever we are doing today. So for this, a new skill development corporation has been formed, and different ministries and departments, including Planning Commission, have stepped up their activities. So I request people sitting in this hall to take advantage of the policies for skilling of the country. Very attractive schemes have been made. You can see the website of our ministry and also website of the Skill Development Corporation. During slowdown, the associations had met the Honorable Prime Minister and he had appointed a task force under his Principal Secretary, Mr. Nair. That task force report is out. And for the first time, the task force looked at all the aspects of the industry, from credit, technology, labor issues, exit policies, revenue issues, infrastructure. So we have before us a very good blueprint, what is to be done. And I like to tell you that many of the things have already been done, because many times it was felt that reports come out but not much is done, implementation is weak. For this, the Honorable Prime Minister has himself set up a steering group under his Principal Secretary, and he has formed a council under his chairmanship. So very high level of attention is being given to this sector. One of the problems relating to credit, lot has happened. Mr. Arun Mehra is here. He is heading the review committee relating to credit. Also, there was a stipulation that up to 5 lakhs there will be no collection, especially for first generation entrepreneurs, it becomes very difficult. So now it has been increased to 10 lakhs to increase the flow of credit. 40% priority sector lending is earmarked for this sector, which includes micro and small sector. And out of this, whatever total credit is flowing for micro-small sector, 60% should go to micro-sector. So this group has also said that currently it is around 45%. It should go to 60%, and RBI has also increased in 3 years' time the credit to this sector will reach 60%. This will mean substantial outflow of money for this sector. Also 10% new accounts, because first generation entrepreneurs find it very difficult to get loans. So 10% new accounts have to be opened by every bank. So this will definitely create a good atmosphere. So overall, we have tried to create an enabling environment where it is becoming very easy to get credit. Also, we have schemes like Prime Minister's Employment Generation Program, where we are giving 35% of margin money. So entrepreneur may have to only chip in only 5% of the for special categories and 10% for general categories. So this is also a very attractive scheme. We have a scheme called Credit Guarantee Scheme run by Government of India funds through SIDBI, where up to 1 crore of rupees, no collaterals are required. So this is another very good scheme. In order to attract people to go for better technologies, we have a scheme called Credit Linked Capital Subsidy, where we are giving 15% money. Basically, our approach is to work through clusters, where we feel that we can reach more people with less effort, with less money. So we have a very attractive scheme where for every cluster, we can give up to 15 crores rupees. Also, to improve the industry infrastructure in states, which is one of the constraints, Government of India is willing to give 10 crores for improving the existing industrial estates. To improve the competitiveness, we have a host of programs under the aegis of National Manufacturing Competitiveness Programs. These programs definitely help the competitiveness. You can see our website. Also, in order to bridge the gap, because India is a very big country, entrepreneurs are in remote villages, in forested areas. So this ministry is starting a call center where anybody can approach. It will can be approached by landline, by mobile, and I feel that this will definitely provide good services relating to credit, relating to technology, and any other information a person seeks. And this will have facilities both for Hindi and English. Another important area is the procurement policy. We are in touch with all the important ministries and trying to convince them. I'd like to thank the Honorable Minister that his ministry has supported us. There are certain issues which have been raised by defense and some other ministries about quality and timely supplies. So here in this August hall, there are so many entrepreneurs. I request them that we have to rise to the requirement of the buyers. Sometimes parliamentary forces say that they are not able to get the quality of products they need. In fact, one very bad example, I'll say that somebody supplied trunks to them because it is because to know the gauge of the steel, one has to weigh the. So they had put some small sandbags in it to increase the weight. So I request that quality is very important, otherwise this procurement policy will come under a lot of fire. So this is very, very important, timely supply and quality. And I am hopeful that we will be able to push 20% procurement of all government departments and PSUs. This will be a great boost. Also, NSIC is trying to help in different ways. We are strengthening NSIC by inducting about 300 crores worth of equity. And this will definitely help all the industry, especially the smaller ones, because they have one scheme where they take big orders and distribute to the smaller industry. So this is one area. They have a market intelligence cell. They have also a call center where they can help. Then they have infodiary services. They have websites. In fact, it is very difficult for micro, small, and medium enterprise to have offices or LISA abroad. So they are having a website which can be used for e-commerce and e-trading. I will not take much of your time, but I would like to definitely compliment the Economic Times, FISMI, for organizing this conference, which is very well attended. The first conference really raised a lot of issues, and the brochures and the material which came out of that really helped the ministry in formulating many new proposals. We are always looking for ideas. We are always looking for solutions, and I'm sure this summit will also provide us some more insights into the problems and the solutions. Thank you.